streamer here. No. Quita, aka Blazing Quita. Welcome, my friends, to the stream. Welcome to Sin TV. Today's featured game is a game that was completely under the radar, my friends, for me. I've never even heard this game before until I actually went on MMOs.com, and that's how I found out about Titan Siege. So that's what we're going to be playing today. Guys, the configuration for this game was a biatch. So first off, I have to play this on like low settings. And then every time you open up this game, it does not save your resolution settings. You constantly have to reset it over and over and over again, which is super annoying. Pardon me. Also, later on in the stream, find out more about our juicy topic of the day. I have two perspectives on, is PC gaming really dying? Because as of late, PC sales have been slowly declining. However, the popularity of PC gaming continues to rise like this. So we're going to get more into it. But guys, let's get down to business here. Here's a little Riot talk for you. This whole week, guys, I have just been sitting back in awe and just being so humbled and so grateful for your support. You guys constantly send me messages of hope, of appreciation, of gratefulness, of thankfulness. And guys, I can't thank you enough for that love and that support. Like, if you guys are like my family, like I always say. Also, I gotta give a special shout out to Mikey. Check out his stream, which is at Mikhail W. Johnson. Really funny guy, down to earth, very sweet, very nice guy. I am so blessed to have him as a friend. And that's what Twitch does. It goes beyond the gaming, my friends. This is a community of people that share, you know, like-minded interests. And yeah, we love gaming, or yeah, we love being creative. And I'm just so blessed that I've met people like him, Jackie from Just J2J. Also, shout outs to Justin as well. I mean, just wonderful people who embrace me and who accept this alternative girl as who I am. And guys, that's all I've been doing this week. I've just really kind of kept it low. I'm still looking for a full-time job, something that I would love to be able to work from home, because then that'd be great. It would give me more time to work on the show here. And I did a complete revamp of Sin TV, as you know, as well as my other rockin' program, The Curvy Metalhead Show. I'm including more interviews now with guests that I have on the program. And guys, I am completely booked for the month of January in regards to interviews. Like, it's crazy. Like, the Curvy Metalhead Show, as well as Sin TV, I have my first interview coming up next week. I'm so excited. He's a really cool guy. And on top of that too, I have been in this frenzy, guys, of buying tons of games. Like, I got this really cool game that's made by a Netherland company, and it's called Kin. And I feel like I have a niche sometimes. I am a huge, huge sucker for a good ARPG. I'm gonna get back into playing Diablo 3 and the Sims Life Stories, because you guys love when I talk the drama that is happening to my girl Riley. So we'll get into that as well. But guys, I feel so good. I feel I'm in a much better place than I have ever been in my life. And I feel so blessed, and I give God the glory for that. Just because 2015 was not an easy year for me. As you can see too, you know, I'm rocking the natural. You know, I gotta sexify. I gotta look sexy for you guys today. And also, I realize my audience is some really good-looking people, man. I mean, there are some fine, fine men up in here. And shout-outs to my ladies, too, looking good, you know, representing. Because you guys are helping to debunk these stereotypes in the geek community sometimes. Because you know how sometimes geeks are looked at as being, like, stinky, and we smell bad, and we're, like, crazy and stuff like that. And that's not true at all. So, guys, I really appreciate it. Let's waste no time. Let's get into Titan Siege. Okay, so Titan Siege, this is coming from MMORPG.com. Great website, guys, if you want some more really in-depth information about MMOs that are currently out, in the past, and are, you know, upcoming. So, Titan Siege is an MMORPG being developed, of course, it's already been developed, by Chengdu Storm Totem Studio, a subsidiary of BL Tech, and published on the COG platform. Based on the legends of Northern Europe, Greece, and Egypt, the game pits humans against the legendary Titans and involves the conflicts between the two Titan parties, domination and destruction. Okay, no. Among other gameplay modes, Titan Siege allows players to engage in pet battles, siegecraft, and fixed and random instances. Pardon me. So, guys, I'm really looking forward to play this for you today. But, guys, you know the other thing that pisses me off? I never had a chance to play Arc Lord 2. Now, I want to find out, is Arc Lord the first one still running? Because I would love to play that too, you know? But Arc Lord 2 went down. But, guys, I've just been playing a lot of just ARPGs. Like, I really like a good ARPG. And I also just like your generic JRPGs, like JRPGs as well. Like, you know, Final Fantasy and Xenosaga and all of that. I actually have Xenosaga on my list of games that I want to play for you too. As well as the worst RPG of all time. The soundtrack is TheBomb.com. But what I'm talking about, guys, is Unlimited Saga. I will put my heart through the pain of playing that game. But dang it, the soundtrack. The soundtrack is amazing. Hey, we have T-H. Hey, how you doing? Oh, I'm sorry, my friends. I don't have song requests. The reason why I don't do song requests, and I'll tell you guys why, is because for some reason, like, there's just some people who like coming in chat and being racially offensive and being racially disrespectful. And here's the bottom line, because Stone Cold said so. No, I'm kidding. I am not tolerating racism, like racist comments and racism in my chat. I am not tolerating that anymore. And you know why? Because number one, I deserve to be here just like any other streamer. Yes, I know my skin color is different. I know I've been sun. It seems like I've been sunburning for like 10 years, right? Okay. But I know I did. Hey, we have another fan here, another friend. Thank you for coming in. Like, I know I deserve to be here. So if you don't like me, then go suck on a ball sack. Like, go do that. No, I'm kidding. JK. But I mean, go somewhere else. Like, I am not tolerating this tomfoolery anymore from people. Like, I just think that we all deserve to be here. We all do this because we love you guys, you know? Maybe I'm just speaking for myself. Let me retract that. I'm speaking for myself. Okay, I'm here because I love that I have a group of people that love what I do. You know, that respect what I do. And I am not tolerating racist stuff. If you come in here, and I see it's already starting, so I'm gonna give you a warning. But if you come in here and you take it to that degree, pardon me here. Oh man, my throat is killing me today, guys. So if you come in here and you start that type of stuff, I'm done. Like, I'm not tolerating it. You know, it's not funny. It's not something that people should be joking with. Because, you know, here's the thing. I am the type of person that I embrace everybody. I don't care if you're white. I don't care if you're black. I don't care if you're Puerto Rican. I don't care if you are native or if you are biracial, triracial, whatever. Gay, straight, Christian, or not. Whatever you want to identify with. That's why I started this show. Was because it's time for our society to just understand that there are going to be different people, and there are going to be cultural differences, and that's it. I'm not gonna sit here and get, pissed. Like, you guys wanna come and piss me off? That's fine. Like, you can come say what you wanna say, but I will say this, though, is I'm not tolerating it. If you don't like me, fine. Say that you don't like me. That's okay. I respect you, for respecting me, and I'll respect you for coming on here. But the bottom line is, my friends, that I am here to educate. I am here to give my opinions, and if you don't like my opinions, that is absolutely fine. I am not forcing you to be here. You are in no obligation to be here. But the reason why I do this is because I love you guys. And I'm saying this from the bottom of my heart, because if it was not for you guys, oh, sorry. I know I get emotional all the time, but if it was not for you guys, let me tell you, this is one part of my day that I enjoy doing. Okay? When I'm offline, my life is not always easy. Pardon me, it's not. I deal with a lot. People saying because I'm a person of color, I shouldn't like anime. I shouldn't like video games. As a black woman, I'm supposed to be a certain way. But I choose not to appropriate, and I also choose to give different perspectives. If you don't like black people, that's fine. If you don't like a certain cultural group, that is to your discretion. But don't come in my show, on my show, and interrupt because you just want to start something, So I respect you. If you come in here, that means you have a higher level of intellectual understanding. And that's what I support. I don't care what race you are, I don't care whatever you come from. I just want this place to be a place where people can, they can ex express themselves, but express themselves respectfully. But I'm not gonna tolerate indecency anymore because I deserve to be here. My race should not be anything that should stop me from what I want to achieve. And I'm going to do it. And that is why I'm here. Okay? So I just wanted to get that out of the way. Let's get into some Titan Siege here, because I could get into that conversation, but I think it's already been addressed, and I'm not tolerating it. If you come in here, you say something disrespectful, it's offending other people in chat, you're done. And you will be banned. And that is it. I come here as I'm a very nice person, but the last couple of times, guys, has been so inappropriate and it's been so immature, and I give everybody decency. And if you don't like me because I'm black, that's fine. That's absolutely fine. But don't watch my show if you don't like what I represent, because I'm wasting your time and then you're wasting my time as well. Okay? So I just wanted to get that out of the way. Let's get into this game. We're playing Titan Siege. I have Karlaxx looking super fine with her amazing hair. So let's get into the game here. And this is like any other MMORPG. You have your WASD, you have your mouse here, and you're zooming in, with your roll. Your scroller here, and you also move in WASD. But as you can see, if you have a lower end computer like I do, you gotta play this on low settings, my friends. Now, I know it doesn't look the best, it's not on ultra, but that's just how it goes. So your chat will hover, it'll open up this way. You have your world, you have region, team, if you're in a guild. And for a game starting off, I mean, that's some pretty high HP here. Your map, of course, is here. You can zoom in and you can zoom out. Not much of an enlargement here. But yeah, that's pretty much it, guys. That's just the basics here. You can change your perspective like in any MMO with your right, And yeah, I mean, it's pretty cool. Let me zoom in and show you my character here so you can see her. So there's my girl looking fast, darling. Okay, so there we go. And let me Let me scroll out and get back to the... Yeah, there we go. Alright, so let's talk to Mr. Rylus here. Okay, so we have to request reply here, and there's no voiceover, which is really annoying if you ask me. So, we did complete that one, and let's submit it. Okay, so... Alright, so we have to use our normal attack to train the dead man. So let's go do that. And let me zoom out a little bit more so you can see a better depth of field here. So as you can see, this game's very self-explanatory. You got that arrow showing you where you need to go. The map is kind of clustered, though. I will say that. That's one thing I don't like. Pardon me here. To like itch my ears in here. It's like a... It's like a vice here on my head. It's just not a good time. Okay, so... Alright, so now we have to do an attack here. So, one is our main attack. So that's all you gotta do. That's all you gotta do. It's just one. You can pick up items just doing that. So this is it, guys. This is all you're doing. This is just a basic attack. So you have like a regular swing. Okay, so you're just doing attacks here. And then that's it. So that's all you have to do. So let's go back. So as you can see, a lot of typos. Not a good time. So, alright. So we are ready to rock. And now... Okay, so we have a new cutscene here. I like the music, though. But this game needs voiceovers. Because I think without the voiceovers, it really takes away from... Because can you imagine this game with voiceover, guys? It would be absolutely amazing. Like, this would be fantastic. So... Well, there's one sound for you. Excuse me, guys. Like Star Wars, medieval style. Boom. But see, my favorite ARPG right now is Diablo 3. I could play Diablo 3, like, all night long. Like Lionel Richie, you know? It's really great. It's a really cool game. I mean, it's very consistent. But I really like the voiceovers. The voiceovers really add to the lore. And my character, you know, I can relate to her. It's such a really cool game. And guys, here's one tip too about makeup. Okay, if you're gonna wear, like, put mascara on, make sure you put clear mascara. My lashes are like this. Like, I have like a crack eye. Like that is not cute. Okay, so the barbarian troops have a lot of attack, so this is never good. Alright, so we need to find Fleur in the camp here. So as we can see here, we are following to get to Fleur. So, I mean, this game, honestly, you just click and move, like that's it. I don't see anything really special about this. All right, and it has that kind of Terra-like type sound, which is interesting. All right, so now we have to enter the Untamed City and find Mulev. All right, so let's go do that. Look at that, I'm walking like I'm in Blade and Effing Soul. Look at me go. Look at me run. So you can actually, as you can see here, there are like little lights here that you can... go. So it's good to burn calories like this, my friends. Here we go, so you can see better perspective. So we're in the middle of a fight. All right, so let's... Oh, okay, so we gotta enter the city here. Okay, so we have to kill a barbarian soldier. All right, so where the heck are these? Oh, there they are. See, it's a lot of clutter though. It's a lot of clutter. So let me help attack. So there's one. Oh! Oh, no, you don't. Come on. So right click is to attack, guys. All right, there we go. All right, so finish that crap. So let's go back. All right, there we go. So that's all you're doing in this game. Like, seriously. Like, and even on low settings, guys, I'm still getting, like, 25 frames. It's so bad. I give up now. All right, so... All right, so I gotta kill two beast soldiers. Okay. So I got that ammo box. All right, let me see what I gotta do here. Okay. So I gotta collect that and go to Borlur. Do you see all these typos, guys? Like, this is the worst game that I've played with typos here. I mean, the concept is interesting, but they just need to work on the text of the game. I think that would really help them. And as you can see, I am taking bombs to help out me lord. There I am. Going up the tower. Yeah, I am totally playing some Diablo 3 today, for sure. Okay, so we got that. Alright. So now we have to pass through the battlefield of the Untamed City and find Sergeant Sarman and talk to him. Okay, so let's go find that fool. Let's go find that fool. So... Okay, so let's get into our featured topic, our juicy topic of the day, guys. This is coming from digitaltrends.com. PC sales are slumping, but PC gaming is booming, okay? Even as more traditional computer users continue to transition, there we go, to tablets and smartphones for their online and workplace interactions, PC gaming remains as strong as ever, and the sector is showing an interesting trend, as reflected in the latest International Data Corporation, which is known as IDC's numbers. Overall PC sales in the fourth quarter of 2015 were 7.1 million, according to the recent IDC report. That's a lot of computers, okay? Pardon me, guys. Whew. Gross. You gotta love indigestion. That represents a drop of as much as 10.6% year-on-year as per PC World. This doesn't account for the 2-in-1 tablets, however, which have become a massive market in their own right and could easily be regarded as part of the netbook family. While overall PC sales might be down, though, high-end desktops and laptops for gaming are doing better than ever, which is interesting. And this is kind of in regards to like Alienware and then also the Oculus. I mean, that thing, the Oculus is like $600. Like, that's, whew, you know, that's kind of ridiculous. But everybody really thinks that VR is gonna do well. But guys, remember in the 80s and the 90s they tried doing VR too, and look what happened to that. It was the cost of the technology and the graphics quality over exceeded the actual cost that people were willing to spend on it. And that's when VR kind of started to die. And that's what kind of ended up happening in a way. I mean, with Nintendo, remember they tried the Virtual Boy. And then like every other system after that had its own VR kind of like headset you put on. And you would like, so only certain games too would be VR friendly too. So maybe with the Oculus Rift, there might be, you know, some, I mean, definitely some advancements. And I saw one of the cool games, you know, I saw one of the games that you could like play on it too. And I thought that was really, it was really interesting. And you kind of do feel like you're in the game, but we're not to the point where it's like Star Trek, where it's like a hologram. And can you imagine, guys, if it was a hologram, then I wouldn't even need a boyfriend. Like, I could just have a hologram of, like, Bradley Cooper. Dawn. No. Oh, JK, JK, guys. But that would still be funny as heck, though. It would be a really, yeah, it would be a really, really interesting time. But here's what they predict, though. I thought this was interesting, too. And apparently, the game just stopped doing what it... Oh, so it's showing me, okay, well, I know. And I know. Okay, well, oh, I apparently died for some random reason. Interesting. And I'm in, like, a normal... Okay. Alright, so... I gained some, you know, HP, which is always good. Okay, so I don't know how I died, because... And this is, like, a completely new area. It's kind of funny, though, don't you think? But that's just how it goes. Okay, so I need to get my HP... back up, but it's gonna regenerate, so parting the red screen here. All right, so let's go and talk to okay, so we finished that. All right, we gained the experience. All right, awesome, let's get the heck out of here. So let's go reply to Trudeau and like not die. I don't even, so that was like the that was the introduction to the game, so that was just weird as heck. So now we're actually in the game now. So interesting. All right, so let's go talk. Yep, which we did. Okay, so the weather was fine that day and everybody was carrying on. And then there's this random demonic being that just shows up like, hey, what's up, guys? And then, of course, he's like, but I am a knight with nice armor and thus makes me better than you, O fine mayor. And then he's just like, yep, that's right. I'm a boss with a skirt. A boss with a skirt. Okay. That would be funny if I could kind of illustrate it that way. But here's an interesting thing about the article again. It says, but gaming PCs aren't alone in having a relative rosy forecast. Despite problems in sales over recent months, the IDC predicts that desktops and laptops of all kinds will receive a big boost over the next year. Corporations around the world are expected to upgrade their millions of antiquated systems to utilize the new Windows 10 operating system, many before July cutoff for the free upgrade. And that should account for a huge number of PC sales. But here's the thing, people... don't seem to kind of like understand about this whole PC situation too. Hey, we got Mateo 2700, yo, with like 50 O's, right? Well, welcome to the stream, my friend. I appreciate you being here. We are playing Titan Siege, and this is like worst game ever. So no, I'm kidding. No, it's actually okay. It's all right. Alright, so let's talk to that chief. Okay, so let's reply to Rideau here. So we're doing that, and bup, did that. Gained some more experience. I don't even know what level I am. Let's find this out. Oh, I'm still level 1. And look, I'm like at 80%. So, Mateo, how you doing? What's going on, my friend? But guys, like I said, okay, in regards... yeah, I'm doing good, man. So in regards to that article about PC gaming, you know, the decline, but there's still an increase though. Here's the thing about Windows 10. Gamers are split right down the middle with Windows 10. I know for me, I'm currently gaming on Windows 8.1 and it works perfectly for me. Well, that's good to know. Hey, do what you gotta do. No, I'm kidding, JK. But in regards to the whole battle between like Windows 10, you know, Windows 8.1, and some people still game on 7, okay? And it also depends regionally too, because there are going to be some parts of the world where they may not be able to equip Windows 10 or to have a computer that fits those specifications as well. And trust me, you know, that's where the battle is, because there are some games that are not working part of me here in Windows 10. So, for example, like I remember it was like Tomb Raider, Angel of Darkness. Some people had problems playing that on Windows 10. I know some people have had problems with OBS working in Windows 10. So, and most of the time for me, 7 and 8 have been pretty stable for me in regards to like what I do. So it's very true. I mean, you have to be kind of aware of what platform, because that's what I tell people. Everybody wants to just upgrade to Windows 10. We have a new friend in here. Thank you for coming in. I appreciate you being here. And the thing that also kind of makes me laugh too is that there people are so easy to like upgrade to Windows 10, like right away. People are like, "Hey, Windows 10's out, let's get it." But what I always tell people is you want to give an operating system a little bit of time. Let them like work out the kinks and stuff before you like update to it. Because for me, I almost did upgrade to Windows 10. Then I come to find out that some people who have OBS was having some problems with it. And even some games haven't caught up to Windows 10 optimization. So one thing I do is before anything, before updating period, is you want to make sure that you check what type of games you're going to be playing. And if your games are all optimized for Windows 10, then I say go ahead. But also you make sure you have the right, the proper disk space, you know, make sure that you have a drive, maybe an extra drive, and then you load your games on there. So that way your system doesn't become kind of slowed down and clunky. Because some people who have updated to Windows 10 have had this problem. So I got some gold. Yay for gold. All right, so apparently I have skills, and this skill tree is very similar to like Van Helsing. So all you do is you just add it and boom, we have a new skill. This is Shield Bash. And let's see here. Okay, so then you want to hit confirm. And see, it's like in Chinese, which is interesting. So, all right, let's go with that. And okay, so we are good to go on that. I'm going to put my new skill here, and I'll also put my new skill here as well. So I just have 1, 2, and 3 instead of like having to hit C plus 1, C plus 2, and all of that. So, and I noticed too, the screen is like super cluttered. It is not a good time. So let's look at the request bulletin, which is this. And apparently, okay, focusing on the objectives. So we did that. All right, level 2. Good time. We have level 2. Oh my gosh. Okay, so hostile towards humans. And a giant bear, well, no duh, would be hostile. And we also have a giant horn. Okay, that's cool. Hey, we have another friend in here. Thank you for watching, my friend. I appreciate you being here. Chat room is open. Let's talk. Let's get it. You know how it goes. No, but that was a really dumb cutscene, not gonna lie. Okay, so we are talking to the bishop here, who looks like Katya from RuPaul's Drag Race. Doesn't this bishop look like a little... No, not really. I love Katya from RuPaul's Drag Race. She makes me laugh. Alright, so we got some more experience. So, it's pretty easy to gain experience in this game, guys. Like, and there's like never-ending quests. But I don't think this game is going to be around for too long, to be honest. I don't really think so. And look at this gentleman. Yeah, I'm a boss. Because I put my thumbs up in the air. So, oh my gosh. All right, let's get that copper too. But yeah, guys, before you upgrade to any operating system, you better make sure that the games that you're going to be playing, don't assume that Windows 10 is going to just like make things compatible, because sometimes there might be a game that's only exclusively, you know, for Windows 8 compatibility or Windows 7. So you always want to make sure, check all that business before making an upgrade. It will save you time and headache. Like, I had to do a complete factory reset on my computer because of stuff like this. And then I had to reinstall Windows 8.1. And guys, let me tell you, installing Windows 8.1 is a biatch. It took a while. It took a while with the computer that I have. But like you guys know, the main thing I'm trying to do right now is to upgrade my video card so that I can play games like Terra. So I got 2 more months to go. I'm saving every penny, and I can finally get this stupid card, and then I'll start to play some even better games than what I've been playing. All right, so let's go kill some baby boars. Ha 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 ha! Not classy. Okay, so. All right, let me zoom in so you can see how horrendously ugly these boars are. Look at this baby boar, like this is horrible. All right. Let's see, can I pick up this item? Look, it sinks into the ground. Oh, so I don't even have to. Sweet. Okay. What is going on here? This is an ugly boar. All right. And I like it sinks into the ground after it dies. Like, whoa, whoa, whoa. Hey, we got 5 friendly people in here. Well, probably half you guys are a-holes, but that's okay. No, I'm kidding. JK. People be taking me so seriously, though. Like, I'll make a joke on Twitter and people are like, you're an a-hole. And I'm like, guys, I'm joking. Like, it's a good time. All right. All right. And they don't even attack you back either. So let's kill some more of these baby boars because I need some experience. Like, oh my god. So, I was talking to my friend. Okay, no, I'm not. I'm not gonna be like that because that would be absurd for me to be like that. Hey! We've got a new follower! Thank you so much for following, darling. I really appreciate it. And let me get my notifications up. I always forget this step. I am such an a-hole for this. You know, I bet you guys are like, oh my gosh, her show is so unprofessional. Like, oh, did the wrong thing here. Let me exit out of that. Okay, so let me go to my Twitchy alerts. Because I'm totally, you know, I'm such a professional doing this right now. You guys have full permission to make fun of me in chat today for that and be like, ha, she's not professional. Like, you can say stuff like that. It's absolutely fine. I will be getting cough drops. So we have Matt Cam 34. Thank you for following me, darling. Really appreciate it. I appreciate that you guys take the time to follow in the first place. All right, so let me make sure I got that going. All right, there we go. All right, so then I know that you guys, who you guys are following. So I'll be like, hey, no, I'm kidding. So I know that you're following, which is cool. Appreciate the love. All right, let's get back into killing these stupid baby boars. And I like that sound. It's like, hoo-eh. Like she really means business. All right. And then you just walk over, and that's how you get the coin. All right, so we finished that little quest, so let's go reply to Dushane or whatever. Shanaynay. So, I'm so ridiculous. Oh, look at those sheep. I should have killed some of those and taken the wool and called myself a Highlander. Yeah! All right, there we go. So no room for weaklings, you're right about that. All right, so let's get that copper. All right, get that experience. And we're gonna be to level 3 really soon. All right, so we gotta get some more of these stupid adult boars. Because the baby ones are not cutting it. Not cutting it. All right, there we go. So those are some wild boars. Let's go get that one. That is one ugly mofo. Do you see how ugly these things are? Man, not a good time. All right, there we go. Alright, let me back up here so you guys can see the catastrophe. Alright, so that's one. Alright, so yeah, we're just like slashing through them here. Oh, get that coin. Warriors gotta make the monies. Honeys. Okay. Oh my gosh. And guys, I'm so excited. Tomorrow I'm getting Guild Wars 2 Heart of Thrones expansion. I heard it was orgasmic. So I have to get my hands on this bad boy. Alright, so let's go back. We killed these stupid boars. Alright, so... I like this. Exiting battle. Like, it's something so epic. Alright, so let's turn around here. So you guys can see the beautiful imagery. I mean, the game is graphically beautiful. Like, no lie. It's just the typos and, like, all this other stuff is what's causing the game to really be bad. But the story would be good if there was voiceover. That's the main thing. And pardon me if I'm quiet in between because I'm like letting my voice rest here. Alright, so we got some more experience. Cutscene! That is the most constipated boar walk I've ever seen. I can't even imitate it because it was that bad. Okay. So you can left click to go into rest mode. So let's left click. So we're in a meditative state. Okay, that's really unique. I like how I get up like I'm constipated though. That's pretty sweet. Alright, so let's go get the... Okay. So we got a boss that we have to fight. So this is going to be good. Oh my gosh, can you feel the anticipation? Alright, so let's go kill this mofo. Alright. See, I don't like this, because it's like, graphically, this game is total clock blocking. Alright, let's go. Let's fight, Fair Maiden. There we go. Man, this is a tough boss. I think I'm gonna die up in here. Alright. Yep. I can't believe I won that. Hey, Mikey! Sound like a little girl. Hey, Mikey, what's up? Oh my gosh. Guys, check out his stream. Mikhail W. Johnson, man. Mikey is the... Thanks, man, for watching this horrible stream today. I really appreciate you being here. We also have Mateo 2700, who's probably sleeping right now. No. Oh my gosh, this game is awful. You guys have full permission to clown me in chat for this tomfoolery. All right, so we beat the stupid boss that, like, pretty much almost killed me. Like, I can feel my lifeline just... That's what happens to me in... Guys! Tomorrow... Blade and Soul. I'm not gonna have a life tomorrow. Like... I'm totally going to be playing Blade and Soul, like, hardcore. I mean, it's the most overly hyped game of 2015-2016. So... I definitely have to give it a shot, man. Oh, so the game that I'm actually playing is it's called Titan Siege. One moment, guys. I actually have to answer the phone. Alrighty, your sexy Australian black girl's back. No, I'm playing. Yeah, that was just my friend. She was like, "Hello," and then I was like, "Hello," and then in true Apple iPhone fashion, it hung up, and I'm like, "Hello, hi, is anyone there? Are you dead?" That's just like it's one of those horrible like horror movies, But yeah. No, Mikey, you're so awesome. And of course she calls back, but I'm just gonna let it go because hey, I'm playing a game, dang it. I'm playing a game! Okay, so no, it's all good. So the game that I'm playing today, Mikey, is called Titan Siege. It's kinda like it has an emphasis to it like PvP from what I was reading. And also too, there is like this PvE kind of a little, I would say it's similar to like Terra. That's the best way to describe it, but it's not as good as Terra. So, yeah. So no. But oh my gosh, guys. I gained some experience. I know. Round of applause. But yeah, it has been crazy, like for me. I mean, this week has been insane. Like I've spent most of my week at home. I'm gonna be working all through the weekend, so I try to play like every other day. Let me actually sit down and gain some energy here. Okay, so as you can see, this is me resting in a very comfortable position. I think this game came out recently. Yeah, it does feel like PS1 graphics for sure. But let me take a look to see how I have the information here to see how old this game is. Actually, the game came out in March of it says March. But see, this is what's interesting. So it says that well, this is according to MMOs.com. It's a PvP, pardon me, PvP MMO, so this will be interesting. And it says it's supposed to come out March 8th of this year. So that's quite an interesting. So, all right, so I'm done being on my knees. Okay, no, that's a horrible joke. I shall burn for that. So I like that meditation disappeared. So let's go talk to the bishop, looking mighty fine. Would you tap this? I would say yes. Okay, no. All right. Yep, got the letter of recommendation. Alrighty. Yeah, it's really new, but like nobody's in here. It's ridiculous. So, okay. So let me check my functions. Oh, okay. This is if I ever get friends. I never get friends in online games. I just get all these guys who are like, "Hey, you're pretty hot. We should like go out." And it's like, okay, guys, let me give you some pointers here. Well, not all, but some. Okay. If you really like a lady, all you have to do is just be a proper gentleman. That's like all we ask. Just be a proper gentleman, be yourself, and just don't be a jerk off to us, and then everything will be great. Like, that's all we ask for. Yeah, it does look like. Yeah, it does look like EverQuest. Yeah. Oh, speaking of EverQuest, like, I tried to download EverQuest 2 because I really wanted to play that for you guys. And that is, like, straight up jacked up my computer. Like, my monitors started, like, flashing and crap. So now I know that I can't play EverQuest 2. So it seems to me that I will be in the market for getting a computer sooner than what I thought. Sucks to be me. So it's like, here we go. Another like $700, $800 right there. This has not been my, it has not been a good start to my year. First, we lost David Bowie. Then we lost Lemmy Kilmister, and then Natalie Cole. What a great way to start off 2016. Ugh. Thank you, Mikey. See, Mikey is a proper gentleman. And this is why I have mega, like, respect for him. Because he understands. You understand. So, oh my gosh. So, all right, let's look at the skill hotkeys here. Yeah, let's get that. Tenacity. Totally need some of that. Okay, let's see what else I need. I know you guys are probably like, what is she on? Oh my gosh. Crazy, crazy, crazy. Oh yeah, I totally will check out that link, man. Totally will check it out. For sure. Okay, I think we're good. Yep. Okay. So, alright, let's confirm that. Yeah, yeah. And, you know, I also want to try playing Moonlight Blade and Monster Hunter. Looks pretty sweet. Not even gonna lie. Okay, so this is a weapon type. Okay, and this is a defense type. Okay, so let's put... Since I don't have a shield yet... what the heck? Okay, so... Okay, we'll just put it there. Okay. Sounds like a plan. Let's rock and roll. Alright, so let's talk to Thras and see what's up with him. Oh, really? Okay, I have to check that out. Because I am in the ballpark of getting something probably new in the future. Probably going to spend around like maybe $800-900. I just want to get something where it's like, alright, I got it. Maybe I need to upgrade the graphics card in the future. Because I am so sick of playing these, like, lower-end games. Which is good, though, because there is a market for that. Because not everybody can afford it. But dang it, I want to play some Terra. I want to see my Slayer's pores. That's what I want to see. Like, that's what I'm aiming for. But, it's so frustrating, guys. I don't even know. Oh, yeah, Linus. Yeah, he's really... I wish he didn't have a girlfriend. That guy is hot, man. I would give him tech tips any day. No. But, yeah, he's really cool. I really like him. If you guys haven't heard of Linus Tech Tips, you are not a true techie. This guy has been around from the long haul, way, way back in the day. And he does these really straight to the point, really good reviews on peripherals, on hardware, software. Like, he is the man. Like, if you really want to learn how to, like, get the right type of parts, definitely check him out, you know? I forgot the other guy. Forgot his name. TechSource. Yeah, TechSource is really good, too. He has this thing called, Setup Wars. And what Setup Wars is you can submit a photo of your like setup. Mine is like straight up ghetto. Like if I showed you my setup, you guys would puke for like a half an hour. Like you would puke like Family Guy puke where it's like bah, 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 like that. Oh my gosh, that was horrible. But no, like, you can send in your setup, and then he does these really decent critiques and stuff like that. The main problem that I have with my setup, though, is cable management. That's the main thing I need to work on, is getting some good, like, cable management. I know Mikey's just like, I am not gonna talk to this girl. She's, like, super psycho. No kidding, no. Alright, so, giant bird on the... Let's go kill some birds. These are some ugly birds. What the heck is these? The ugliest birds. This is why I play Guild Wars, guys. This is why I play Guild Wars. Okay. So, yeah, I just got Guild Wars Game of the Year edition, so I did do a video on that. And I'm getting Guild Wars 2 Heart of Thorns. I'm not gonna have a life! I'm not gonna have a life. It's gonna be a good time. Alright, so let's kill this stupid bird. All you can do is peck, so, you know, not much you can do to me. Well, no, I take it back. It's a level 5. Yeah, they look like heroin trocobos. That's what they look like. Yeah, they do look like... They look like chocobos that have not, like, paid their rent whatsoever. So, pay your rent. No, this is horrible. This is absolutely horrible. Wait, let me try these new, like, attacks that I have. Okay. There we go. I wish I had that ability, like, in Guild Wars where you can, quicken your, attack. So, you know, I shouldn't fight. Let me rest for a minute. I think that would be smart. Alright, guys, let's go into that other part of the argument. This is coming from, if you really want a good podcast, guys, listen to PC Gamer Podcast. I love the PC, I think it's the PC Morning Show. They're fantastic, too. And they're really funny. But the other thing is, it would be really cool to get a show with, like, ladies, and like, a battle of the sexes kind of thing would be cool, and kind of just talking, you know, differences in opinions, like how the ladies feel about gaming versus the guys. But I have not found a lot of ladies that have the balls to talk. Like, it seems to be few of us here. It's like, there's so many girls who want to be pretty, but, like, very few want to give an intellectual opinion, maybe? Like, that would be really cool to do. Wow, I healed very quickly. Okay, I need to stop being on my knees before the creepy guys come in here. Okay, so, alright, there we go. No. But yeah, this is an event strider. Like, what the heck does that even mean? It should just be like, they should just put broke chocobo. That would be pretty funny. Broke chocobos. But yeah, so... tired of fighting these stupid birds. But no, I'm kidding. It's pretty, you know... I think I'll play this game when I really just need to hack and slash. Once in a while. But yeah, guys, coming from PCGamer.com, PC sales suffer record fall. Okay, market research at the giant IDC is reporting a record fall in PC shipments in the last 3 months of 2015, down 10.6% on the same period the year before. IDC figures include Macs, but Apple shipments actually grew 5%, and most of those people are hipsters, okay? So it's the hipsters that buy the Mac stuff. So I'm a hipster. Serious, no. So, the figures for mass market stalwarts like Dell, Lenovo, and HP are ugly. I know that Dell isn't a retailer of choice for gaming rigs, but everybody loves Alienware. No. So, which includes everyone else, suffered a 21.9% plunge. Let's not panic, firstly, because there was expected to extent. The launch of Windows 10 got people deliberating when the best to upgrade. Amen to that. And those who aren't hopping to run Crysis are... Crysis? If I could run Crysis on this computer, I would hug myself. Seriously. Even people with the best graphics card, those AAA games are just hard to run, period. But I digress. Are increasingly picking up tablets and hybrid abominations. Secondly, all-in-one computers. Secondly, custom PC retailer Origin, Kevin Walowski, say that 10 times. It's like Lalueski or something, you know. Polish names are hard to say, okay? German names too. Has revealed that the company enjoyed double-digit growth. IDC doesn't address high-end PCs specifically, but it's also been a quiet year from components, with no new generation of NVIDIA's GPUs to prompt upgrades, and the late arrival of Skylake CPUs pushing purchases back. In any case, PC gamers are prone to replacing parts over whole PCs. So, like I said earlier, guys, to be honest with you, if you're going to make an upgrade to Windows 10, please make sure you check that your games are all going to be compatible. Don't go and moan and groan to Microsoft like, oh, my games are not working properly. Well, you should have checked the specifications before making an upgrade. I personally decided to keep my desktop with Windows 8.1 Until OBS becomes compatible for Windows 10, and all of my games are gonna work on Windows 10. Because I already had a problem running Sims Life Stories, actually. And I had, it, and this was funny too, Granado Espada. The reason why some people have a problem on Windows 8.1 with it is there's actually a security update that completely blocks Granado Espada from working right. Like, you get this blank kind of error screen, and let's rest for a moment. But yeah, it was really crazy, man. Oh, really? It runs well for you? Oh, it runs Sims 2 fine? Well, see, Mikey is the source of information. You know? And yeah, that's what I heard too with Alienware, is that ever since Dell bought out, you know, bought Alienware, then it went wah, 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 and then that was like the end of it, but... You know, everybody's got their personal preferences on what peripherals they like and what, you know, brands or whatever that they like. Oh, really? You've had no problems with Windows 10? I mean, for me, I'm just nervous, maybe. Maybe that might be it. Maybe I'm just like, because, like, for me, I'm so used to, like, for many of you guys know, I work in the tech-related field, so... I'm so used to getting people coming in with their computers, right? And they're just having problems with Windows 10. And I'm just like, you know, let me wait a little bit, you know? But Windows 10 is going to be expensive as heck to upgrade. So I'm kind of glad that they're doing the free upgrade with that. But see, the thing though, Mikey, like, I agree with you with Steam. Some of my games are non-Steam related. And that's what kind of makes me hesitate a little bit. Just because some of my games run really well on 7 and like 8, because the clients are compatible for that. But that's what I'm kind of nervous about. Due to the privacy of the work that I do, unfortunately I can't reveal where I work. So it's like confidential, so I can't, unfortunately. But... It's just kind of frustrating when I see, like, the people that I work with, you know, their upgrade didn't load right, and that's some of the stuff I'm concerned about, because it's like, I already have this computer set up the way it's supposed to be set up, and yeah, okay, we killed these birds, let's get the heck out of this bird land. Stupid birds. Okay, there we go. No, JK. But yeah, that's the thing, like, PC gaming, I would say maybe the reason why it's kind of declining a little bit could be the cost. I mean, guys, we got the PS4 and the Xbox One out here for $350, and you get like a 500 gigabyte hard drive, some come with free games, so that's the competition, you know? And before the PC fanboys get your panties in a bunch... I play both, okay? I have console. You know, I started off on console. I did play PC games, like, a little bit, but I was playing games that were more of, like, you know, your gateway stuff, you know, like Street Fighter, you know, virtual, you know, fighter, like, that type of stuff. So, like, that's what I started with, like, that type of stuff. And then after that, I just lost interest, you know, because PC gaming at that time, it was a very elitist thing, you know, it's not as like how it is now, where it's like, it's pretty much open game for anybody to play. But at that time, those parts were like $5,000, you know, or more. So when people complain about building a computer at $700-$800, I'm like, guys, that's really nothing, you know? And you don't have to be brand loyal either. That's what I always tell people too. Like, you don't have to buy all Razer or all particular brand, you know? Like, with Logitech, I will say, if you do get their Spectrum headset, you get the keyboard, and you get the new mouse that came out, then... they kind of all sync together, which is kind of unique in regards to the RGB, the new Spectrum mouse that just came out. So I thought that was interesting, but you really don't have to be brand loyal like that, you know? Are there brands that I really like? Like, I love TTE Sports. I'm a huge fan of their stuff. And the reason why is because it's very, you know, they make professional products that are very sturdy. Like, my keyboard and my mouse together was like $80, you know, because I know how to find good deals, you know. But yeah, my keyboard is TTE Sports, correction here. My mouse is a company from China called Zilotes, and it does the job. Like, you know, I have a Razer Chroma headset, as you can see, but there are so many brands. Like, the one thing I tell people about PC gaming, though, is trial and error. Like, you gotta try the product and see. Like, for me, I hate Logitech with a burning passion. And the reason why is because, well, story time. So I got a their G, like, 930s or the 933s. And as soon as I put it on, everything was cool. It was very comfortable. But then both sides of my headset cracked. And I hadn't even had it for, like, 3 months. And then it started having this kind of, like spotting kind of problem where it would just kind of clear in, clear out, clear in, clear out. It was really, really strange. Just like this. Like, do you see this? Oh gosh, I can't with this game today. Okay, so let's try that. Okay, so we confirm. Okay, so this is Battlefield Advancement. Okay, so I will probably need this to speed up my attacks. All right, so let's go get some eggs like a boss. Oh no, I think, well, did I get some eggs? I don't think I did. We'll see. Oh, you have the Krakens? Yeah, those are pretty, they're okay. You know, I mean, if I really want to be fangirly, I like Corsair. I do like some of Razer's products, but I just think the price point's kind of absurd. All right, let's get that egg. That's a really big egg coming from such a small hole. Oh, you really want to start this, homie? Let's go. There we go. All right, let's try that Battlefield Advancement. Jeez, this is the worst battle ever. My gosh, it's not that serious. There we go. So we got that. Get this egg. Alright. Of course these birds are gonna be angry I took their eggs. That's so typical, right? Man, this bird's like... like... it's very... it's serious. Alright, there we go. There we go. I don't blame these birds for being pissed. I would be pissed too if someone took my swag. I would be very pissed. Man, the, like, cooldown time is atrocious in this game. Alright, there we go. What the heck is this? Believe we have a leaf. What is this? Let's see here. Can I get it? Three. Oh, healing potion. Sweet. Okay, so these are, of course, your backpack. Do you see how many slots we have here? This is atrocious. Okay, so we have a healing potion. Okay, I can't use that to level 10. Oh, gift pack. All right, let's see what's in here. Oh, okay. Alright, so we got a ring. That's sweet. Oh, we got some potions and crap. Okay, invincibility potion. Alright, that's a good thing. Alright, let's get one more egg and get the heck out of here, because, you know. Oh, okay. Yeah, I was gonna try streaming with my I have a shoot. I'm totally gonna die here. What's the name of the mic? I have a snowball from Blue Mic. So it's pretty cool. I'm gonna die, guys. Watch. And I died. Okay. Alright, so I could respawn. What a jerk. But I finished the quest. Deuces! Oh my gosh. Oh, and I can swim as well. Had no idea. I'm learning new things, my friends. But yeah, guys, like, it was really interesting, though, when I first started. Like, at first, I was a Razor fangirl. It's like, Razor are the only products that I'm gonna buy. So I just, like, got, Razor stuff. But then I realized, I was like, this is really expensive. Like, there's gotta be other brands. Just like Corsair, too, can be a little pricey. I wanted to try their Void headset, because I heard it was pretty decent. As you can see, I'm not really as brand loyal like I used to be, though. Like, honestly. Yeah, I heard the snowball is really good for that, so I was gonna actually try it next time and see how that actually works for me, to see if the mic quality is better than this headset. And secondly, the thing I don't like about Razer's headsets is it feels like a vice. Like, it's so uncomfortable, and it's just so much tension, like, here in my ears. So you can imagine after I'm playing maybe a 3-hour or 4-hour game, you know, I'm just like, oh, like, my head hurts so bad. So I'm going to, maybe I'll switch to the USB snowball next week to see if that makes a difference. Like, if you guys would like that, and see. But okay, so we finished that. Oh, look at this good Englishman. He's like, oh, thank you. Oh, okay, we got some level 1 scroll. That's sweet. Oh, sweet, I get rewards. Okay, so what the heck do I want? Well, since I'm a warrior, I definitely want that. Sweet. Okay, we got a cutscene. Cutscenes are always good. Look at this ugly bird. Oh boy. This does not look like a good time. Alright, so let's check out that scroll. Alright, so let's use it. ID scroll. Wait till the... Oh, so you can identify the item. Okay, that's cool. Alright, I'll have to use that later. Huh. Do I have a better sword now? Let's see. Unlock that. The activity. Am I able to... Oh, sweet. I can collect that. Heck yeah. Okay. And let's see what else that I can use. Okay. Oh, I think I can get something else. Earn activity. Sweet. Okay. Oh, okay. So I'm not to that point yet. Okay. That's cool. That is pretty sweet. So let's go give that blueprint wherever the heck that person is. And look at this text. Like, oh, I can't even. All right, let me turn around here. I just want you guys to see the actual scenery of how the game looks like. It looks pretty decent. Oh, yeah. Totally, Mikey, man. My ears are cooking briskets in here. Like, by the time I finish, like, a 3-hour session or something, I'm like... like, I'm doing that. I'm like, my hands are all sweaty and my hair is all greasy in my face. Like... No, that's horrible. Absolutely horrible. But yeah, it was quite a boring week for me, actually. Nothing really exciting was happening. Oh my gosh, I'm totally gonna be going to bed early, though, because I have like an 8.5-hour like shift tomorrow. Work. There's just sometimes I just wish I was just famous, you know, where I like... I'd just be on the red carpet, you know, hanging out with the crew or something. No. That would be kind of nice, you know, but oh, I'm already level 5. Hooray! And I didn't even know. This is horrible. All right, let's check this out. Ba 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 ba. Okay, this is a bad mamma jamma bird. All right, let's see here. Oh, this is a tough battle. See if I'm prepared for this. I think I should be okay. Whoa. Man, this bird has crazy abilities, man. This is a long battle. I should have leveled up. I'm such an idiot. Stupid. Come on. There you go. We're almost there. Almost there. Bam. And we got a dead bird. Alright. So we finished that mess. Did we get anything? I went through all that pain and suffering and got nothing. What a Daria moment. Oh my gosh. Ridiculous. Crap. Dang it. Alright, there we go. I'm not even gonna play with that. Let's get the heck out of here. I know this bird's gonna chase me down, but that's okay. Or maybe not. That's pretty sweet. Wow, we've been talking about birds for like half of this show. Like, that's really hilarious. So, Mikey, what else have you been up to, man? I gotta get you on stream here. We gotta, like, play a game sometime. That'd be pretty sweet. Ridiculous here. Oh my gosh. Okay, so found another story too, guys, while we're waiting for my butt to continue burning calories down this fine lake of fantasy. So this is coming from digitaltrends.com. And what's interesting about this story, though, is EA has decided to launch what's called Origin Access, okay? So it's a new PC gaming service that gives subscribers full access to games such as Dragon Age Inquisition, which is awesome from what I heard. I'm playing through Origins right now. The only reason why I won't play it on this stream is because of the M rate, like the super like M rating, and there's sexual content, so I couldn't upload that to YouTube. So that's the only reason why I can't play the game. Alright, so let's give him that. Okay, so I want that dagger, dang it. Huzzah! Okay, so level 6. We are moving on up to the east side. Okay, so let's... Can I... drag it with the left button and ensure... Okay, so we gotta do this. Alright, so let's do that. Oh, so it increases my spirit. Okay, that's good to know. Okay. Why can't I have this stupid sword? Alright, let's see. Oh, so I need this. Okay, so let's do that. Okay, so it identifies it. Sweet! Okay. So, it's a lot stronger, so we'll see how this goes. Okay. No! Okay, so I think we're returning. Well, okay, so we went to a different area here. Interesting. So that takes you back to the village. So that's good to know. Look at all these peeps. There's, like, no one in this server. How embarrassing is this? Oh, well, someone's looking for a guild. Well, that's good. Okay, so let me see here. Excuse me. So this person is looking for a guild. Okay, let's see if they'll join our team. That'll be interesting. See if we can get some like multiplayer-ish going on. All right. So add friend. Okay, and then you can add the person's name. All right, that's pretty sweet. All right, so let's go back to ham, cooking some ham. His culinary skills suck balls. Okay, no, it's horrible. All right. Okay. So assigning pets for. Okay, so we gotta get our pet drugs. Who the heck gets pet? Oh, gosh. Giving me a migraine, guys. I'm getting a migraine. I can feel it. Okay, there we go. All right, so we completed that. All right. Oh, yay! I have a friend. This is great. All right, and he has joined the Encourage. All right, so our combat went up, which is always a good thing. Okay, so let's see here. Man, I wish the camera would just move with you. That would be heavenly. All right, so let's look at our skills here. Oh, we got a couple. All right, so where the heck do I want to put this? There. Okay, let's put it there and put one here for crush. All right, so we'll do that. Yep, you betcha. Okay, so we have Roar, okay, which allows you to chant. Okay, can we like have this, please? Okay. So you have to click and drag these, which is kind of annoying if you think about it. All right, so we're getting a little bit better. But yeah, about this Origins thing. So the Origins access also grants members early access. To upcoming games along with discounts and exclusive perks. So it launches this week and it has a lineup of 15 games from EA's like back catalog. So it's, for example, Battlefield 4, The Sims 3, Need for Speed Rivals, SimCity, Battlefield 3. Like you have Battlefield 4, so why would you need Battlefield 3? This War Is Mine, Dead Space 3. And then you have to pay a $5 subscription fee. Okay, and then you're given full version to the accents of the game. So it's like a play on demand without time limits. So what EA was mentioning too, and this is just me paraphrasing now, is they are going to continue to add new games to the lineup. And what's cool too is that the Origin Access subscribers receive a 10% discount on all Origin purchases too. So Origin Access, it follows up on EA Access. Okay, so this was a similar service that was put on for the Xbox One in 2014. So it's gonna be really interesting because this is just my two cents on this thing here. Yeah, no, I was saying to backtrack. I was mentioning that, yeah, sometimes we should pick a game and game together. That would be really sweet. Or have you come on as a co-host, because what I announced today is I am having people come on as like guest co-host, and then if my audience is interested, I'm gonna go through an audition process with them. Because I'm trying to keep this show classy, okay? I'm not gonna just have any Tom, Dick, and Harry on here. And people will be like, "Ooh, that's bougie." But no, it's like I work really hard to bring the quality that I bring, so I want to have people that actually take it seriously and are decent. You know what I mean? I think anybody who's a streamer can understand that. All right, so let's see here. So we gotta go talk to the evaluator here. All right, so let me go finish this drug quest. Getting drugs for me, pet. All right. I like that. You have come to the right person. Alright, so we can pick. Alright, so let's just pick a pet egg. Alright. So now it's explaining in a how you can trade with other people. That's cool. Alright, I know. Alright, and let's hit F. And then you can get the pet drugs, which is always a good thing. Okay, so let's go back and talk to Loma. This is a kind of interesting game, but it's very generic, so I agree with that. But like I was mentioning, kind of backtracking with Origins, like this subscription service, I feel it's kind of pointless, though. Because we have Steam, we have Humble Bundle, we have... There's so many places that you can get your games that why on earth would I pay a subscription to play games that I could get from Steam or games that I could buy from Amazon, you know, or eBay or something like that. Like, that's kind of defeats the purpose. You know what I mean? Like, I think that if you're going to do anything with a subscription service, I always tell people you want to make it exclusive. You want to make it in a way that entices people to get a subscription. So for example, like, I'll give an example of this. Crunchyroll, right? When you get this subscription, you get it without commercials, you know? So that's enticing because who wants to watch, you know, you want to watch your anime, you want to enjoy it, but dang it, there's all these stupid commercials. And here's a way. And then the other thing that's nice too is you get early access on episodes that get posted too, which is a nice plus too. So that I could see paying, and the subscription is really cheap, guys. So if you're interested in watching more of those obscure type shows, go to crunchyroll.com is the website for that. So yeah, that'd be great. We'll have to talk about that, Mikey, and find out like what games that you're playing and stuff like that. And then, or even not, I would like just have you on and we could like talk and stuff because you're like hilarious and you have so much knowledge too. Like, Mikey has helped me a lot, guys, with understanding the components in my system. And also, like, I've been watching his stream and I've been watching my other friends. Shout outs to Lady Miss 80s, and that has helped me to get a lot better with what I do, you know. But the thing I always tell people is just be yourself when you stream. Like, don't be a personality like that. Like, people are getting tired of that. Like, people come here because they want something that's organic, you know, something that's refreshing and different. And that's what I've been doing. So, and oh, that's good to know that iron ore, you know, can be used to make a weapon. Now that's a chocobo. No kidding, no. Oh gosh. All right. So as you can see, this is like the easiest game ever here. It may get difficult maybe a little bit later on or something, but. I'm not seeing anything that's like, you know, rocking my socks here, so to be honest. And I don't even know where the heck my teammate is. And we got people speaking in like 10 different languages, which is awesome. So, all right, so let's go kill some spiders. Because, you know, I love killing spiders. All right, let's go. There we go. Some mutant spiders. There we go. So that's one. And this is a two. There we go. Ooh, poison. And here's some more. And that's a three. There we go. Okay. Where the heck is the other one? Ah, there's one here. Hello, Mr. Spider. There we go. Alright. Okay. Just taking them out. Clearing names. Okay. Oh, gosh. Yeah, it would be cool, because you have a great personality, Mikey. Like, I've been telling, like, my friends about Mikey and just how awesome he is, like... And I'm not saying that because he's in the chat room right now, but, you know. So really pleasant to talk to. It's just refreshing. You guys know exactly what I mean. Like, it's just refreshing to like talk to someone that understands you and doesn't think you're some kind of weirdo. Because I swear, like, most of the friends that I've had in my past, not even gonna lie, they suck, you know? Like, they think what I'm interested in is kind of like, you know, is not their scope. Or even sometimes, like with my coworkers too, for example, like, if I start talking about anime or something, they're like, oh, I don't like anime. And like, people automatically assume that anime is gonna be childish, you know? But there's so many different genres, you know? I mean, there's Jose, and there's, you know, Shoujo, and Shoen, and, you know, I like harems and reversal harems are really funny. Love comedy, love romance. You know, I like some of the action. The mecha ones are okay, but I like, shoot, what's that show? What was the one? I think Gundam Wing I like. And then I just started watching this one I just finished called Diabolical Lovers New Blood, and that was hilarious. So I will be doing a review on that. And I finished the first season of that too. So I'm just trying to like catch up, you know. Alright, let's get these stupid spider quests out of the way. And I love the fact I killed all these spiders and then you gave me like crap experience. Like, come on. But guys, we're already up to level 8. So that's pretty sweet. So we're going into a different layer now. So we are going into the spiders layer. So, and apparently this is a safe region, even though there are, like, tons of spiders. And I love how I just, like, went through that, which is really funny. So let's go back. That was really dumb. Like, I just walked in and walked out. Like, ratchet! Okay. That was really funny. Okay, so go there. So we're in the Loran Plains. This is hilarious. But, oh my gosh, I love Sailor Moon. Oh my gosh, that was like my gateway. Sailor Moon was my gateway. Like, I always dreamed, like, when I was younger, that I would, like, meet someone like Tuxedo Mask, and that would be the end of it, right? Okay. But I think every girl dreams of that, of being whisked away by a man who speaks in haikus. Like, I think that's, like, what every girl should want, right? Okay. Well, that's good to know. All right. Okay. Okay, so we have to talk to the Silver Woos or whatever. Okay. So there's a gigantic spider who lays. That's an ugly mofo right there. Ah! Horrible. Absolutely horrible. Okay, so it says seal can be obtained by killing elite monsters, and it's essential in forming gear. So that's good to know. Let's see here. Oh, we have some new enemies over there as well. Okay, well, that sounds like a plan. Alright, well guys, I can't play any more of this. This is giving me, like, a gamer, like, erectile dysfunction. That is what I'm having right now. So, I mean, this game, guys, Titan Siege, is just like any other doggone MMO, the classic ones that are out there. It does not excite me, it does not make me want to play it again. The storyline is laissez-faire. The combat's okay, but it's too clunky. I think that if they actually worked on the interface and they actually worked on like putting some voiceovers in, this game would probably be pretty decent. But it's just not that great. I'm not learning anything. It's just not rocking my socks right now. That's what's up. Okay, so let's just go over what people thought of the game. And this is coming from my favorite website called Metacritic.com. Okay, and as you can see, I mean, across the board, there are not any reviews on this game because it's such an underground, like, kind of game. But MMOs, though, always comes through. And this is what they thought were some of the pros and cons. The graphics are okay. I mean, graphically, I can show you guys, like, look, it's very beautiful. It looks, like PS1 type graphics. It looks pretty decent. Another thing they mentioned too, it's a seamless world, which is, yeah, the loading times are really great. I mean, you just go from one realm to another. And then on top of that, here are some of the cons. So cons were, it was a postponed Western release. It took forever for this game to come out. There are tons of bugs and like so much clunkiness. I mean, look, some of the characters that when I was checking my skill tree and updating it had Chinese characters. I wish I could read Chinese. That would be great. And I can also tell that most of the people that play this game, as you can see here, and of course, the person left the team. Well, of course, that always happens to me. No one wants to play with me. Okay, no, I'm not gonna freak out like that. As you can see here, it clearly, I mean, people are not, they're speaking different languages, so that may be a little bit difficult. Maybe I need to start learning some new languages. Maybe I just need to just capture a sexy, Asian like husband. That would be great. No. Horrible advertisement. Like, please marry me. I'm desperate. So on top of that, yeah, the game is not fully translated like the way it should be. I mean, there's tons of typos. I mean, it's so bad. As much as I gave this game some hope, I do like this. Well, I'm not gonna be a Debbie Downer. I do like the skill tree. The skill tree is really nice in this game. And if you're looking for more of that lower res requirements, then I would say yeah. But if you see a game that not a lot of people are talking about, then you know that yeah. And I wouldn't even spend money in the cash shop, But the auto questing is nice though, just in case if you're new and you're like, how the heck do I get around? But it's a pro and con sometimes with the auto questing, you know what I mean? This is particularly the same thing that we see in like browser-based MMOs. You either really like it or you really hate it. Another thing too that I thought that was really kind of interesting, about the game too was the fact that like not a lot of people know about it. Like, I was just like, why would you release a game and not a lot of. Maybe it's bigger overseas, because this is definitely like the type of style that you would see like overseas, like places like Asia, stuff like that, which is where majority of these MMOs like come from. But particularly, guys, I am very excited for Hero Wars. I cannot wait until that one comes out eventually. Hopefully, Tree of Savior 2, I would like to play that. And also, I would love to play the new patch that's coming out for Diablo 3. That's gonna be pretty sweet. So, Mikey, before I head out here, my friend, do you have any suggestions of games that I should play in the future? Any suggestions? Because I have been getting a lot of people want me to play like Mario Party. Some people wanting for me to play Minecraft. Some other people wanting for me to play first person shooters, which I suck at. I'm just I will, like, I'll leave Call of Duty and Counter-Strike for the professionals. I knew. Yeah, someone wanted for me to play a Star Wars game. Someone wanted for me to play the Knights of the Old Republic or Battlefront. But I would love to see their recommendation. And this will completely go against my love of Star Trek. So I'll get the Trekkies in here being like, "You're a hypocrite." Nah. No. Oh gosh. People are like leaving the room. They're like, "This girl is a carpet muncher." Okay, so Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic 1 or 2. Okay, I'm going to put this down right now. That's what every video game critic that I have checked out has said, that these are like really good games and they're both excellent. Yeah, I'll have to see if they're on Steam, and I'll probably buy them like tomorrow and play it back to back, and then watch. I'll have all these people. Well, thanks to the pricks that came in here the last time and spoiled the Star Wars movie for me, so I'm not even gonna watch it. I was so pissed. Yeah, I heard the MMO is kind of eh. I heard it was okay, but oh, they are? Okay, I'll have to get both of them. I also was going to start playing some Lord of the Rings games. I have a couple for like PS2 and stuff. Like, I've just been focusing a lot more on retro gaming because the new stuff is just, it's like everybody's playing Fallout 4, so that's why I don't even see people anymore. They're just like, "I gotta finish it." Yeah, so. Okay, so I'll have to put that on the list here. Yeah, that's what I heard. They're pretty old, but people consider them to be classics. So I try to really incorporate, like, here's a couple of other games people want me to play. People want me to play The Witcher, the third game, and some other people want for me to play Star Trek, like online or something like that too, to check that out. So I'll have to check that out as well. So other people are like, Street Fighter. When Street Fighter V comes out, like, my computer will probably self-destruct when I try to play that. And yeah, I know everyone. Yeah, everyone keeps telling me that. They're like, "Fallout 4 is amazing." And I'm like, my computer will explode if I played that, man. Like, no way I would be able to play that. But yeah, guys, this game. I mean, if I'm even sitting back lounging like this, this game sucks really bad. It's not as decent as I thought. And I have to give an honest opinion, you know? I mean, this is not me knocking the developers of this game, because their company is very innovative. And, I just feel that they need to just work on translation issues. They need to work on making sure that guilds are a more active part of this game. Because one thing I tell people is, guilds and community make a really huge, it makes a large impact in regards to when it comes to a game's success. I mean, you could have a game with an awesome storyline, all that jazz, but if it's not decent, then forget about it. If you don't have a good community or people who take things really seriously, it's not gonna. Look at that water. Dang, that's nice. But yeah. Yeah, that's what's. Yeah, a funny thing is, people have to. You can get Skyrim really cheap. You can also get Oblivion really cheap and Morrowind really cheap now. But yeah, people really, really, really like them. And they're super long. I would play Dragon Age Origins, but it's just the sexual content that I can't put that on YouTube, which sucks. I would love to play all the Dragon Age games because they're so dang good. The storyline's really good. The voices, I like games with voiceovers too. That's why I like Blade and Soul. I really enjoy that game as well. And yeah, dang it, I really, really want to All right, let's go beat this honkin'. I don't even think I have a chance. Let me even pause this. I think I'm not even to the right level. Dang it. Well, yeah, screw it. But yeah, so yeah, that's what everyone's saying. So okay, I will put these all down. See, Mikey, you're a genius, man. You're giving me some really good ideas of games to play. Because I'm always looking for something to try out. I will be getting back on the browser-based scene too, because I try to play a little bit of everything, because you know, browser games are great. Like, you can find a good one with good graphics. Like, it's really good. I mean, there was Chrono Wars, and if they could do voiceovers too, that would make the game even better, to be honest. Let me even see what this quest is even about. Okay, let's see. Let me put Oblivion down. I'm just putting down. You have any more suggestions, Mikey? Because that would really help a girl out here too. Yeah, but I think I would just play Oblivion just to hear Patrick Stewart's voice, you know. Oh gosh. And watch me die like 50,000 times too. I will be playing, I forgot the name of the game now, how to pronounce it. I think it's called Kin. Yeah, Kin. I will be playing Kin because, you know, me and ARPG, so, I'll be playing that down. But yeah, audio suggestions, always appreciative. How is that game graphically? Like, is it harsh on your system or no? Or I'll have to check that out too. Alright, so we got some good suggestions from Mr. Mikey here. So, we have Witcher 3, which that will probably happen once I get a better graphics card in this bad boy. We also have Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic 1 and 2, so I'll have to check it out. And some people say I should play the online one, and I'm just like, okay. Oh, so the strange feeling slowly goes away. That's good to know. And then we have Skyrim, Oblivion, and Morrowind. So best be checking that bad boy out for shizzle nizzle. So yeah, those are all really good choices. Everyone keeps telling me to play these games, Skyrim and all that. Yeah, some people are telling me to play Mass Effect 2. Wow, it's like, where are your matters? It's like, whatever, suck it. Okay, there we go. Wow, I am like in such a catty mood. All right, so we have obtained the crystal. Okay. Oh, okay, so I can't use this until... Oh, so I'll need to use it in the correct location. Well, that's kind of funny. Okay, so then we gotta go to that main queen. Get her going. The heck? Oh, we have interns here. See, these interns, it's a crappy time for these fellas, I swear. But all right, I think I'm gonna do is I'll play for like 2 hours. Yeah, let's do that. Okay, so let me just get more of these spiders here, get my levels up. I think that would be good to do that. Because if I'm fighting a giant spider, I think it would be a good idea. Okay, so it's telling me to join a guild, but it's like, okay, where do I join guilds? Like, it has no... I mean, it doesn't show... Oh, there's guild. Okay. Oh, so we have a couple guilds here, which is kind of surprising. Usually what I tend to do is... See, I really wish this was like Blade and Soul, where they give you like a description. But let's take a look though. This one's pretty full though. The Hidden Army, Art of War, Region of Hunters. Not a lot of guilds here. But you know what, for the heck of it, I'm gonna apply to the Hidden Army and see what happens. I think that would be interesting. Oh, yes. Yes, Lineage 2, I actually have downloaded that on Steam. Well, let's see what's coming up, guys. Next time on the stream. Okay. And there's like that 90s like cut, like that 90s transition. So I have a couple actually. So coming up, we have Lineage 2. I'm glad you brought that up. Then we have coming up as well, Granado Espada. Really good soundtrack. It's got that sexy like H&M techno, like that kind of stuff. Then we also have coming up too the games here, Morrowind, Skyrim, Oblivion, and anything else that comes in this brain of mine. Yeah, people were telling me to check out Mass Effect 2. Like they were like, yeah, you should check it out. But I'll see. I think those games like Mass Effect and stuff, like once I get a better. See, the key to all of this for me is a graphics card. Like once I get the graphics card, I found my graphics card, guys. It's an R9 from AMD Radeon, and it's only $169, guys. I was shocked. Like I was like, I am totally gonna get that. Oh, wait, no, I think no, Lineage 2 is on. It's not on Steam. I thought it was. Or maybe it's Lineage, probably, maybe. But yeah, I'll have to check that out too. All right, so man, these things are brutal. All right, so let me sit and get my health going. Okay. So is Lineage 2 available to play? That's what I heard. It's a very popular MMO as well, and people make a big deal out of it though. Like a lot of people were telling me that they're like, you should totally try it, and I was like, yeah, I totally should. All right, let's get that level 6 spider here. I think I'll go to level 9 and it will try the spider and see if we'll see what happens. But yeah, a lot of I like this. This strange feeling grows on you. It's like, what the heck does that even mean? Oh yeah, people play Lineage. Yeah, they say it's really fun. They tend to make a really big deal out of it too. They're like, you should play. Thou hast Lineage. That's good final, you know, it's good fantasy medieval lore. And I was like, yep, we should check it out. So anything with a good fantasy like medieval, I'm there. I'm like, interesting. So you can automatically fight monsters. Auto train. Let that sink in. You know what? Let's try this. I'm curious. Okay. So let's see. Huge HP recovery. Use summon skill. Start auto train. Let's see if this will work. Oh, you have to have battle points. Okay, that's interesting. So apparently you can auto train this so you can gain levels faster, which I think that takes away from the actual like fun of playing the game, but that's just me. Some people like that kind of thing though. All right, let me rest here in the gobbledygook, get my health up. But yeah, so okay, so Lineage 2, I'll have to check that out and see how that one goes. Pardon me, guys. My throat is on fire. Man, I know you guys are gonna be like, why is she clearing her throat? Like a rap song or something. Man. My throat has been like this for quite some time. I just need to get some cough drops. All right. All right, let's check this out too. Oh, and this is some big news here, guys. I just popped this up here. So, Asta, which is another game I really want to try, it's been the open beta has been delayed. So So it says, this is coming from news.mmosite.com. To ensure the release of Asta can meet or even exceed players' expectations, WebZen has decided not to start this free-to-play MMORPG's open beta in January in a responsible manner. Excuse me. This delay is disappointing, but at least it's better than providing us a rough-made Asta. Unfortunately, WebZen does not reveal the launch date of Asta's open beta. According to their latest announcement, WebZen plans to announce the open beta launch date once they are 100% certainly with a reasonable schedule. The delay is particularly related to the voiceover recording and translation process, also some of the technical aspects of the game. I'm completely fine with that. I don't mind waiting for them to give proper voiceover, give proper everything, because the worst thing that can kill an MMO is having a crappy voiceover or having crappy dynamics. So I would rather have them, quite frankly, you know, do it right. Just do it right the first time. And, oh, we have another friend in here. But, yeah, just do it right the first time. I mean, that's just me personally. I would rather go through that process than, than go through having a really crappy game. Like, I would not, want to do that. But I'll keep you guys informed if I got into the Hidden Army Guild just to see how it goes. See if I even got into there. But it seems this game is popular in other parts of the world. So, alright, there we go. Come on, fool. Alright, so we got a potion here. Come on, potion. Oh, okay, I see. So this is something that I have to pick up. Okay, so I got a healing potion because certainly we're going to need that for the battle ahead. I'm getting prepared. Yeah, that's like how it feels. Like, that's so ridiculous. So, and I mean, the leveling up is okay. But you're not even gaining that much experience, you know? So you can tell this is more of like the Asian MMO style. Just because it's a slower grind, you know? Because if I was playing like World of Warcraft, I would probably be done leveling up by now. They've really increased the leveling process in WoW than how it was in the past from what I read. So, you know how it goes. Alright, so let's see here. Get that HP going. Let's see what other news too is going on too. But you know the main thing two people have been talking about is which one is a better MOBA, Heroes of the Storm or League of Legends. Personally for me, I don't play either just because the community is too acidic for me. No offense, but I just can't, you know. It becomes not fun when people take it too seriously. You know, unless you're a competitive player, it's like the purpose of games, it's a form of entertainment. It should be fun. It should not be something that becomes anal retentive. Like, I stopped playing games when, you know, for me for a long time because it became something that was anal retentive. And when people become anal retentive, I just can't play. I can't play a game, man. I can't play it. All right, there we go. Got some more coin. I'm just trying to kill as many of these spiders as I can. Come on. There we go. There. And I love the fact that I'm only gaining like 2 XP. It's like ridiculous. Here. I'm gonna try to fight in another area to see if I can get some more experience here. Because it doesn't seem like I could be fighting like this for hours and nothing would happen. So let me see. Maybe fight some of these wolves and see if that makes a difference. The soundtrack's nice, though, I will say that. And I like the way that I walk, too. It's like, I gotta go shopping. Something like that. Alright, so let's try this wild wolf here. Okay. Let me see here. Well, it's a level 4. I got some DPS, I think, maybe? So I'm not- am I getting any levels? No, I'm not. That's really stupid. That is interesting. So, as I'm fighting these enemies here, I am not gaining any levels. That is interesting. Very interesting. That's very interesting. I am not, no level gain. So it seems to me I have to fight these enemies until I get to the level that I need to be. That is interesting. There we go. So let's just keep fighting these things until I get where I need to be, apparently. Alright. Well, that's kind of annoying. Here we go. Whoa, what the heck is that? Let's see what that is. Okay, so I apparently got a cane. But at least the regeneration in here is good, though. I'll at least give it that. And then let me get that potion. But see, I don't like that. Like, you can pick up coin automatically, but then you have to click on... It's the same thing, like, in Dungeon Fighter Online, too. It's that same... You gotta pick it up the same way, which is kind of annoying. Alright, so I got two. Come on, pick up the coin. There we go. And like the lag too, the pickup coin is quite atrocious. Which is really super annoying. I'm still debating though whether or not I want to get all the expansions for WoW. Yeah, my friend's huge into it. I always wonder what the big deal was. And then I actually played it. And it was funny because so many people were coming in checking it out. I'm like, this is a very, very, very popular game, which I was kind of surprised. All right, see here. Go over here. Come here. Go. Let me rest for a second here and get my HP back up. But yeah, like, I was thinking about getting the battle chest, which comes with all the expansions for the exception of Legion. But I'm still debating, though. Because I'm like, do I really want to pay to play a game, though? Like, I mean, at least with Guild Wars, you pay and then that's it. But, like, with WoW, it's like, if I'm going to, you know, be paying for it, then what I would do is I would get, like, a year subscription. And just do it that way. Because I feel like that would be more cost effective. But the thing about WoW, and this is what my friend was saying too. Pardon me here, just had to adjust. But yeah, the thing my friend was saying about WoW is the fact that you have to, you know, you gotta play it. Or else you feel like you're wasting your money. And that was something that, like, I didn't want to do, you know? So... But yeah, all my friends play it. They think WoW is, you know, amazing. Come on, let's fight. Alrighty. We're at like 70%. I mean, this is ridiculous. So, this is a very grindy game, guys. So, just be prepared for that. It's not a pleasant game. Very grindy. When it comes to that. Okay, let's check this out. Yeah, so this is the type of game you're gonna have to play on like a regular basis to get to the level that you need to be, quite frankly. All right, so, oh, I got some skill points here. What should I do? Let me put that into my shield. Oh no, this is block. Okay, might need that. So I'll put block. You know, actually, I will put block here into 4. Put this back. Or I'll just put that into 9. Because I don't have a shield yet. And then I got to start working on my weapons. But look at, I mean, this is a ridiculous skill tree. I mean, it's pretty large. I mean, not as large as, like, you know, Path of Exile. My gosh. Path of Exile is ridiculous. In regards to the tree system is just insane. Okay. And let's get some. And I don't like the fact that you have to press an extra button just to pick up something. I also was going to buy this other game that's, it has a cult following too, very popular. It's called Sacred. And it just came out with the third game a year ago and people were moaning and groaning and said it was not that great. So I'll have to check that out as well to see if that's a really good game too. All right, let's go up here. Just trying to get around different terrain and stuff. But at least your enemies pop up fast, so at least I'll give the game that. But yeah, I think I pretty much have most of my main games that I want to play though. But it's like, it's bad, but I always have this itch to like buy a new game. Like it just, I feel like I'm not satisfied. Like, I'm not satisfied, which is bad. But Diablo is a game that's really quenching my thirst right now, because I think I'm on act like 4 right now, and the story is juicy. Oh my gosh, the story is so good. I was so impressed with it. All right, let me go into meditation here. You can also stop your meditation with the X key as well. So I'm gonna do that. And then that's, your fury tends to go down, of course, as you meditate as well. But guys, I appreciate you guys coming in. I mean, Mikey is awesome in here. The rest of you guys have been in here. It has been a wonderful stream today. This game is, I know it's kind of boring, but I try everything. You know, I give everything a little bit of a try here. So let's get out of that meditative state. And let's try getting at this spider here. Okay. We're almost halfway. I mean, for me, I just want to... Okay, there's Divine Blessing. What the heck? There we go. Go up here. Check this out. So yeah, you can definitely see here, there is a difference between the, the Asian MMO and the North American. I mean, look how my percentage is at 72% right now. I mean, it's taking forever. Pardon me here. My lips have been getting, like, super dry. There we go. Maybe that's what I get for living in the Midwest, I swear, but in the Midwest, it's just super dry and it snowed. Like, it was ridiculous. I'm so glad it stopped snowing, but yeah, it was absurd. I was just not like, I was not having it. There we go. Kill that one right there. We're not even to like 80%. I mean, it's ridiculous. Oh, All right, let's keep going here. All right, let's try this. Woo! That was pretty epic, though. Not gonna even lie. So that Divine Blessing is a really good move, too. Pardon me here, I'm letting my voice rest a little bit as I'm leveling up here. Yeah, there's not much news, guys. I'm checking out MMO news site here to see if there's anything really going on, but not much. I mean, you know, Skyforge came out with their, you know, new hostile territory area, which is called the Onez Valley. Revelations. Oh my gosh, I want to play this game so bad. Revelations Online is a really cool Chinese fantasy MMORPG, and their open beta is coming out in April. So I'm thinking why this game is not in open beta right now, and the graphics are absolutely just fantastic. So I would love to get my hands on playing that. All right, let me get out of my meditative state here. So at least they have that option with the meditative state so that you can regain your, you know, your XP that way. And we are not even here yet. Have to continue killing spiders here. There we go. You know, I'm gonna be smart here. I have, check gear here. Okay, I have a couple, like, potions here. So, what I'm going to do is I'm gonna be very smart. So, I am gonna put some of these here. All right, get rid of this, right click to get that, and then I am going to put some of this regeneration potion here, because I have a feeling that when I do fight that giant spider, I'm gonna need to be invincible for a little bit. We have Philly 1985666, and he's like, wow, what's up, man? How you doing? What's the wow for? Are you surprised? Are you shocked by my beauty or something? Like, what's up? I'm kidding. Oh, I love joking with you guys. I'm glad that some people appreciate a good sense of humor here. Oh, I see. You know what I'm playing, my friend? I am playing this unknown game that is called, it's called Titan Siege. That's what I'm playing. What would you prefer for me to play? I mean, I try to diversify my playing taste here. I mean, yeah, I do play a lot of like ARPGs and stuff like that, but I just try to show the versatility of what different, you know, what you can do with your computer in regards to gaming, but that's what's up. So, all right, let's see here. So we're getting closer. We're just gonna work our way down as we're heading to the mama spider here. Oh, shoot. I didn't finish it off. Here we go. Let's finish off this one. Come here. And Mikey's back. I think Philly left, though. He was like, this is a dumb game. I hate her, you know. No kidding, JK. Alright, there we go. Pick up something else here. But that's you. I'm so used to that, though, where people are like, what are you playing? And then they're like, this is a dumb game. And I'm like, yeah, I play what I can afford. You know. Okay, so, Philly, you're new to the stream. So, let me clarify, too, with everybody what I do. So, SynTV stands for Smart Intelligent News. And what I try to do, there we go. What I try to do is play, show kind of the versatility in regards to like what quality you can play on a computer. Because originally what I was going to do was I was strictly going to just play Dungeon Fighter online, but then it got repetitive for me. So I decided to kind of be a variety channel. Now I do have games that I review. So this is a game that I'm reviewing, giving my first impression on. But I also play games that I really, really like. So I'm not going to be one of these streamers where it's like you play the same game over and over, which is fine. But I try to kind of try all different type of games, from browser-based to retro gaming systems, like, you know, PS2 I have a lot of games for, to some of the more next gen, which I'm hoping to get into. I'm trying to see if I can get a PS4 to try. But I do first impressions, I do commentary, and we have a blast here. So that's what I do. And am I, Philly asks if I am a people pleaser. No, I'm not. I'm a diva, honey. So I just please myself. I'm kidding. No. Oh gosh, I am absurd. But I try, you know, I listen to audience suggestions, and then I have a list, actually. So, Philly, if there are games that you would like for me to play, let me know. I'll put it on my list. If my computer can handle it, and if I can do it, I do it. So, that's how it goes. Alright, so let's keep moving here, because I figured that would be good to move and groove, right? Let's see, go over here. But I can say from first impression, graphically, like I said earlier, the game is good. It's just without a little bit of voiceover, it really takes away from the game. That's the one thing I will say. Like, it's not giving me joy right now. Not giving me joy. All right, Michael's gonna be back. I'll see you soon. All right. Whoa. I think I'm gonna die here. Okay, no, I got lucky. All right, let me meditate here for a second. Okay, are you a guy going through a transition like me? No, I'm not. I am all woman. And shout outs to my lovely, awesome LGBTQ audience. You guys have supported me from day one, so I appreciate it. But no, I am not going through transition. I am just a woman that has a little bit deeper resonance in her voice, so that's what I am. So, I mean, congratulations for you going through transition. It's not an easy process, so, you know, I definitely want to give you props for that. So, let's see here. Okay, so I should be good. All right, let's check this out. See what's going on here. So Philly, since you brought up why am I not playing my favorite games, I would like to open the floor for you to give me some suggestions of games that you would like to see me play. I mean, for me, this is just a first impression of Titan Siege. This game hasn't been out really as long as I thought for, you know, for English speaking people to play. But I would say the other thing which I agree with MMOs.com on is definitely a lot of grammatical errors that I see in this game. So it's not a good time in regards to that. Let's see here. Oh, we have another friend in here. Thank you for coming. I appreciate you being here. Alright, so we got coins. And if you have to pick up something, you can actually just click your mouse here. You got your hotkeys here. What I think is kind of weird, though, is they have, like, C plus 1 plus 2 plus 3 to, like, 0. So I'm just using 1 through 0 here, so I don't see the benefit of doing that, to be honest. Okay, let's go over here. Let's just keep getting these here. Right, but like I said, guys, if there's any games that you want me to try out, give my first impression on, just let me know. You know, I do play some of my favorites too, which will be coming up. But I try to, you know, play games that I think people should know about, or games that people may not know about, or just a little bit of everything. So I'm like a variety stream would be the best way to describe it. So, and this is a very, you know, culturally accepting, you know, I'm more of a mature gamer, so my audience, you know, tends to be a lot older. But I do get people of all different age, you know, different age ranges that come through, like from, you know, people that are like, I would say maybe 18 and up, you know, but this is a mature stream. So I always tell people that if you can't handle maturity, then this is not going to be the stream for you. I talk a lot about mature subjects. So I know the young people probably would find me a little bit boring. So, but that's who I am. So that's what I represent. All right. So, see, like, you lose HP so fast in this game. Like, it's insane. Like, it's really crazy. Alright, so we're like halfway point here. So, Philly, what type of games do you play? I'm kind of curious if you're still in here, but... Alright. But, like, for me, I play a lot of RPG stuff. That's, like, my core. It's just, I love like medieval fantasy. Sims, I've been playing for a little bit. It's not too bad, but you know. All right. See here. Jeez, this is gonna take me like forever to level up in this game. There we go. See, I just want to be to like level 9. Like, that's what I'm hoping. Come on. There we go. Try 4. Okay. Let's see here. Let me try 7. Woo! That looks powerful right there, my friends. We're just picking up healing potions. I think that would be smart for me to do that. Keep going. Okay. All right, so this is what we're gonna do. I think I am going to try. I'm gonna try this. We're gonna try the big spider and see. If I fail, then I fail, but... Okay. Alright, guys. We're going in. We're trying it. Okay. Interesting. Huh. Interesting. Oh, okay, I see. So we have to lure the monster in. Okay, so let's do that. Okay, so go to our bag. See where that lure is. All right, so that was a trial scroll. See. That's for a mage. Oh, I had a shield and I didn't even know. I am a fool. Okay, so there we go. See here. Okay, so we have to lure the spider queen out. I see. Okay, so I think what I'm gonna do. I think I really should level up, guys. I think that's what I'm gonna do. I really think I should be leveling up. So. I still can't believe I'm gaining 2 XP. Like, that is insane. Like, what? It's like crazy. Okay, let's try that. Aha. Okay, so then you get that shield for a little bit. That's cool. Oh. See what it does here. Absorbs 40% for. Oh, effective for 10 attacks. That's cool. Huh. This is interesting. Okay, so I earned because I've played for like almost 3 hours now. Activity exchange. Okay, I think we're doing good. We're like to that halfway point. All right, let me rest here for a second. Yeah, there's not really much going on in MMO news. Like, I'm not really seeing much. I am not seeing anything that's like really like happening, really popping or anything like that. I'm so excited though. I'm gonna be getting some more like brow products because I've been trying to expand my, like my eyebrow looks and stuff like that. So that's what I've been working on too. I gotta get my like office cleaned up because I swear my office looks like a hot mess. So I have to take care of that too. But nothing really else like exciting going on. Well, something I really wanted to talk about though too is I decided that I was going to do the alternative, what they call the alternative black girl tag or whatever, or alternative black woman tag. I decided to do that just because I think it's important to show that, especially in the different alternative subcultures, that people of color, are present. Like whether you're, Asian, Latino, we can all like work together too. And I love how people try to bypass too that like interracial unions are, they try to make it like, oh yeah, everybody accepts everybody, but we all know that that's not true at all. And I just think it's sad that people that, well, some people, not all people, can be super closed-minded like that. So I always try to keep, an open mind, and I always try to be, accepting. So that's what I try to do, All right, so let's see here. I just think this is so crazy. This increases my like spirit. Come here. There we go. We're almost there, halfway point. Let's talk to this gentleman here. Hit F. Go. He just pretty much says the same thing. This is divine blessing. Oh, pardon me here, guys. Let's see here. Oop, pardon me. Totally froze the game there for a second. Okay, let's see what else is going on here. But yeah, as you can see, guys, in this game, there is a lot of leveling up. A lot of leveling up. Like, not much excitement going on right now. Pick up these items. But at least I will give myself credit. I am picking up a lot of copper, so I know that'll be very essential. I'm gonna try and explore other areas too. All right, so let me hit this stone here, returning back to town. There's gotta be some other places for me to explore besides here. Let's see what's out here. Oh, this is nice. Yeah, I was about to say, I was like, okay, this is the Loran Plains. See, I think, oh yeah, here's some new enemies. Yeah, let's try this out, guys. And I love how in every area too, you got different music going on, so. Sorry, guys, this episode's like all over the place here. Oh yeah, totally. So this is an antelope. So I know I'll start to get some more levelage. Yeah, I totally needed this. Let's hit X here. I mean, one thing I try to do too, guys, is I try to play between like 2 to 3 hours just so that I have that time to really like play the game and, be able to see what it's about. And it looks like we have something over there too, but let me kill these sprinting antelopes. See, I hate this. You only get like 2 XP for this, or EXP. That's so dumb. I want to see what this is about. Interesting. Okay, so at least I found an area that has like enemies that are close in my range here. All right, let's see what this one is. Oh, that's a level 8. Let's go fight that. It's a muscular antelope, so that's serious business. Alright, so we're like the same level. Yes! 6! That's what I'm talking about. Gosh, it's ridiculous. Oh, that's a level 10, so we're not gonna touch that. But we'll touch these though, because I really need the experience here. Excuse me. I gotta get some cough drops before I start doing my other show today too. All right. Get this muscular antelope. There we go. All right, this is good because I really need the levels here. Yeah, there's a whole bunch of them. Hashtag super excited. Right, there we go. And see, the other thing I like too is at least you can fight these enemies one-on-one. You know, they're not like ganging up on you like in Guild Wars. Oh man, that's how I would die all the time, is I would just have these enemies just ganging up on me. It really sucked. I'd be so pissed. Right, there we go. Get some more of this. That muscular antelope. Let's rest again. Hey, we got another viewer in here. Thank you for watching, man. I appreciate it. We are playing through a very interesting game called Titan Siege, and it's okay. I mean, it's just your basic kind of run-of-the-mill MMO. I mean, it's not anything really exciting. It's kind of crazy though. But I have to tell you guys about my weight loss journey. It's going pretty well. Like, I'm noticing, you know, I have a neck now a little bit. You know, I just need to work out regularly. That's the main issue that I've been having, is getting a regular workout schedule. And I was reading this one article, and all it mentioned, guys, was all you have to do is work out like 30 to 45 minutes each day. You know, but everybody's different. So as a disclaimer, I am not a medical professional here. But everybody's gonna be different in the way that they work out their regimen and everything. So for me, what I do is I work out around like 30 to 45 minutes, and I combine it with weights too, because you do need, if you can, to get some weight training. It's really kind of helped me tone out a little bit. I just need to be consistent with it. So I think I'm gonna start working out like 4 to 5 days a week now. And what I do, guys, you'd be very surprised. All I do is Zumba. I am a huge fan of Zumba. Zumba is my thing. I love, you know, doing all that and having a good time with it. Oh, I just love Zumba as much as I love Pitbull. But I tell you, my friends, it's a pretty cool workout. And then I do some pretty much medium like weightlifting, and it's really starting to show. I just need to be more regular with it. I feel like once I get regular with it, then things will start to be a lot better for me. But at least I found this area, so this will kind of help me to level up a little bit more. There we go. I'm getting that experience, which is always a good thing. Just fight the same enemies over and over. Oh. Come here, you muscular antelope. Alrighty. And the cool thing too about Titan Siege is you can play this on a bigger display. And I'm sure once you have it on like higher settings, the game will look a lot better. Another game too I have to get back into is Arc Age, as well as I gotta start getting back into Scarlet Blade too. Scarlet Blade was, it's a funny game. And people give me so much crap for playing it too, which is really funny. All right, we're almost there, guys. Level 9, dag nabbit. All right, let's just do it this way. Pick up, getting a lot of money, so I know I'll be using that real soon. I'll probably never play this game again. I think after doing this review, I totally am gonna delete this game off of my computer. It just doesn't get me going. It's not provocative. No kidding. All right, there we go. Excellent. So you do get a lot of coin with these antelope, though. I will say that. And also, guys, I want to tell you thank you for getting me over 100 follows. I mean, I can't believe it. I am so grateful to you guys for this. Thank you. It means a lot that you guys value what I do, and I will continue to get better and continue to improve and just continue to just really have fun with this. And I also, if you go to youtube.com/user/SINTV now, I also will be doing other videos. So I'll be like reviewing like, you know, geeky type of shows and like just stuff that's really interesting I'll be doing. And then what I decided to do was on my other show, which is called the Curvy Metalhead Show, any kind of like anime show that has like a vampire kind of Rocky type theme, I'm going to be covering it on there. And then everything else, I'll just be covering it on the show here as well. So, and playing games, of course, which is always fun. Okay, let's see here. Come on. I can't believe I've been playing this game, guys, for 3 hours and I have not taken a nap yet. Like, that's insane. I give myself credit, though. Alright, there we go. We are almost there, dang it. Just want to get to, like, level 9 so I can try this spider out. See here. We're very close. I can taste the victory. Keep going here. I'll start talking again once I get to level once I get to level 9. All right. Just trying to rest my voice a little bit here. Oh my gosh, there's like a little duck that is hilarious. You can use any button or press any key to get out of your meditation mode. But guys, we are so close to getting to level 9 because I really want to just beat this doggone spider here. This is a good area to level up, though, I won't lie, because I mean, I'm getting 6 experience over 2. I'm over here. Pretty. We are almost there, guys. Here for a second. And I did see one other person in here, which I thought was kind of interesting. Let's see here. So it seems that not a lot of people play this game, be honest. Doesn't seem to be a very popular title here. Guys, almost to level 9. And what? It took like, it felt like an hour. All right, I am going to take a quick bathroom break here, and then I will be right back. So let me rest. Oh, cool. You can actually see your enemy's thing there. That's pretty cool. All right, so I'm going to be right back. All right, just having to take a quick bathroom break here. Oh gosh, like that's just how it goes. I've been drinking, not even kidding you, so much like water. Like I try to keep myself hydrated, of course, very important to do. Because I remember like when I was a lot younger too, I used to drink like so much like soda, like it was so bad. It was really, really, really bad. So like I always recommend, guys, you want to keep yourself hydrated. You want to make sure that you are, you know, taking good care of yourself, especially gaming, since you're like sitting down for such like long periods of time. All right, so let's get back into the game here. And we are so close to 100 here. I can taste the victory here. And there's like awkward pauses in the soundtrack too. Like I'm not seeing any kind of like looping progression or anything like that. So I think that's kind of weird. All right, level 9. All right, so let's go check our skill points here. And this is more of defense type, so let's look in weaponry type here. Alright, so we have heavy strike, so I'm going to need that. So let's confirm that. Yes. And I think for the heavy strike, I think I'm going to put that here. And just flip that out. So, alright, I'm going to try this out, this heavy strike. So let's try it out here. Yes! That is what I'm talking about. Okay, guys, so let's go fight this spider. I'm ready now since I have heavy strike. So, pretty cool. And then afterwards, I gotta watch the video that Mikey, my friend, sent me in regards to building another like PC in the future. I'm just interested in specs, you know? But everybody's different, though. Pardon me. Woo! Yeah, everybody's different. Everybody's gonna have like different, you know, different gaming, you know, specs and what works for them and what doesn't. Hey, we have a lovely friend here, a viewer in the room. Thank you so much for checking me out. I really appreciate it. It means the world. So now, guys, we are going to head off and we're gonna karate chop this ugly spider here. I just hate spiders. They're gross, man. I hate them. Blech. But that's just how it goes sometimes too. But yeah, I think what I'm gonna do though is I may end up building another computer and just have this one as a backup computer. But I'm gonna do that in the near future. I'm not going to so you guys can see the lovely path and the journey of where I'm headed. But yeah, I'm not going to look at the cute duckies waddling. But yeah, for sure, I am not going to get something I cannot afford, because I think that's the worst thing that you can do to yourself, is to buy something that's just way, way, way too expensive, way out of your price range. But do I think that PC gaming is dying, kind of going back to the topic at hand? Not really. I mean, if PC gaming was dying, Twitch would not be as, you know, successful as it is. I mean, quite frankly. All right, let's see what gift I got here. Let's see, online activity, because I've been playing for almost 3 flipping hours. All right, so let's earn. Well, I'm almost there, but I'm not gonna play this for 5 hours. Trust me, guys, I'm not that I'm not that crazy. All right, so we're headed through. We got little Wolfy Wolfs here. But yeah, I'm gonna be using that heavy strike for that spider, definitely. Because it seems like a nasty spider. This is not like a normal spider. This thing's ready to, like, Chuck Norris, like, karate chop me. And guys, also, too, in the comments below, let me know what are some of your favorite games that you're looking forward to as well. Oh, here's a couple players there. Well, that's good. I'm kind of excited now to see other people, because I've been playing the last like 3 hours by myself here, so this is kind of refreshing. And here I'll let you guys see the scenery too. I mean, it looks good. It's just the, you know, the typos, like stuff like this, it just kind of turns the game off. And this game was around like 3 gigs too. I was like, really? Like, I was kind of surprised that a game of this caliber would be like super heavy too. And yeah, I've been really getting back into the retro gaming thing too. Like, I've really been appreciating playing, you know, old classics and stuff like that. I really enjoy beat-em-ups, like hack and slash type games. Maybe I'm just biased on that. Okay, so now, okay, so this is what it says. Okay, so secret crystal. Using that may lure the spider queen out, okay? And this spider has poisonous. So it says use a secret crystal to lure the spider queen arcanade or something like that. So go to the target area or right click on the item in the quest bar. Okay, so all right, so we're here. Okay, so let's see. Don't have a crystal here, do I? No, this is to go back to town. Let's see here. Let's check my inventory here. We have a lot of coin though. Okay. Oh, here's a quest item. Okay, here, this is what we need. All right, the crystal. All right. You ready, guys? Here she is. All right. What the heck? Okay, let's use that slash. Wow, that's... There we go. Use that heavy strike. There we go. Bam! Game over. So that was pretty epic. Alright, so we finished that. So let's go back and report to Loma. That was the worst battle I've ever seen. Like, I mean, at least I had people helping me out, so I'll give props where props is due. But I thought I was gonna gain a couple levels. Apparently not. So, alright, let me just auto-guide myself here. Where the heck am I going? Okay, there we go. And see, the camera angles are kind of odd too, a little bit, but this is the type of game if you're just starting in MMORPGs, like I said many times today. I mean, this is not the type of game that is going to, you know, be like, wow, you know, get you going and all that. But I will say, if you do have more of a lower resolution system, excuse me, then I would recommend this game, definitely. But if you are the type where, you know, you need some more higher end graphics, then, you know, this is not going to be the type of cup of tea. But as you can see, the textures are pretty decent. I mean, I can't knock it. It's not like, you know, wow, blow you away. But I mean, it does the job here. All right. So we finished. All right. So we finished that too. And we did lure that in. And we gave the disgusting head to her. All right. So, guys, that is it, my friends. 3 hours of Titan Siege. I mean, this game is really not that popular, like I said. I mean, I just found out about it through MMOs. And let me just tell you a little bit. And this is more of a PvP-focused game. But because there's not a lot of people in the server, to be honest, I don't know how successful this game is going to be. I mean, it has a great premise and, you know, a great... I mean, the story seems to be really interesting, but it's not engaging enough where it's like, I want to, you know, play this all the time. I mean, Diablo is that way for me. Like, Diablo 3 is great, guys. I mean, I could play it forever. You know, I'm probably going to play some tonight because I need to get to... I'm on my journey to level 70. And I'm like level 45, so I still have a long way to go. But overall, guys, one thing they did mention too is you can choose between 5 classes, which was what I showed in the beginning. Warrior, Mage, Priest, Voodoo, Elemis, and Assassin. You also can choose in regards to character customization. No alien species or elves, so that's kind of a couple cons for me. The pro, I will say, is a very easy game. It's got the auto pathing, so in case you're like, where the heck am I, you just click that and it takes you where to go. But if I could really give Titan Siege a rating, I would give it a 5 out of 10, just because the story is like, it could be engaging if there was more like voiceover, and then with all the typos and stuff, I think they just need to close this game down, maybe clean up, you know, maybe put some voiceovers and stuff in it, and then maybe it'll be a little bit more engaging. But if it's just completely silent with music, it kind of takes away from the reason why we play MMOs, and that is to enjoy the lore and the story. The other thing too was there's not a lot of people playing it. So if you don't really have a community, then this game's not going to be interesting too. I mean, I tried joining a guild to see, but eh. I'm probably going to delete this game. I'm just not impressed with it. But guys, like I said, if you have any suggestions of games that you would like for me to play in the future, please let me know. I'm always looking for new games. I want to thank everybody that came in here today. I want to thank Mikey too, my new friend who is awesome, for coming in and being such an amazing guy. You know, and helping me out and growing and developing. So let me leave you with some food for thought. So today I mentioned earlier in the stream that, you know, I do this because I love it. I'm not here, you know, to be a hashtag gamer babe. I'm not here to be a female gamer. I'm here for the enjoyment of games. And I just so happen to be a woman. Okay? I started playing games when I was really young. I got into stuff like Ninja Gaiden, and then I worked my way all the way up to playing, PC games. I enjoyed games like, GoldenEye, and I also enjoyed games like Final Fantasy. And, I always love playing games with such a deep, interwoven, rich story. And by playing video games, it helped me to kind of keep myself open-minded when it came to different experiences and meeting people and things like that. But one thing I will say is I enjoy being a geek. I'm proud of being a geek, and I love sharing my geek interests respectfully with people who are interested in who I am and what I do. So when I come on here, guys, I'm not here trying to be something that I'm not. I'm here to, be me. Like, this is me. I love gaming. I love laughing. I love showing you things that may be good. I may show you stuff like this today that may not be the best. But the reason why I started Sin TV was because of a couple reasons. I wanted to create a stream that would be very multiculturally friendly, LGBT friendly, a place that everybody could feel included. Secondly, I created this stream, and to do this, to do Sin TV was because I noticed that there was a lack of awareness of diversity, period. Like, people of color and gaming, I don't really see a lot of articles being, per se, being written about that. And then on top of that, I wanted to share my love of geekery and sharing my experiences and doing reviews and, kind of talking about my journey, being who I am as well. And, Sin TV has now turned into, just like the Curvy Metalhead show, it's turned into a lifestyle kind of channel and on YouTube, and a lifestyle kind of program. I want to share positivity, and I keep it real. I'm going to share opinions that you may not agree with, but I'm going to say this once, and this will be the last time I say this. If you don't like what I do, don't watch. I'm not forcing you to watch. You are watching my, stream because either you find it interesting or it's just something to something you want to watch, maybe, I don't know. But I come on here because I love gaming, I love geekery, and I have been blessed to meet wonderful people on here who have become my friends. Each and every one of you that contribute to this chat, it means a lot to me. Each and every one of you that come in here positive, you encourage me, you tell me to keep going. That's why I'm here, okay? My blackness does not define who I am as a geek or as a gamer. And overall, I just enjoy doing this. I'm not here to be a hashtag gamer babe. Anybody can be a gamer girl or girl gamer, but very few women can be a lady gamer and really come on here and enjoy playing these games. Now, I may not know every single little detail of every single game, but for me, I try to give that first impression. And I also try to represent for the people who may not be as geeky as some of us are. And for the people who want to come into this community and not feel ostracized and not feel like they need to be a certain way in order to be accepted. So, you know what I'm gonna do from now on? I'm just gonna be me. And you can either take it or leave it. If you don't like what I do, like I said before, you don't have to watch this show. But the fact that people come on here and are trying to be ignorant and stuff like that, you know what that's doing? That's causing people to be like, you see? Yeah, I told you, gamer people, the gaming community, geeks and nerds, they are weird. And that's not true. Because we're people just like anybody else in society, And many of you can relate. Like, I grew up in a time where being a geek was not cool. You had to hide the fact sometimes, depending where you live and stuff, So I just want you guys to know why I do this. Like, that's what I want for you guys to know. Like, I'm not here to be something that I'm not. I'm not here to be a drama queen or whatever. I'm just here because I love gaming. I love interacting with you. And if you guys have any suggestions, comments, questions, whatever, I'm on Twitter at SINTV now. You can also check out this archive and the rest of my first impressions and reviews and commentary on youtube.com/user/SINTVnow. I love you guys. I appreciate each and every one of you. And I really, really hope, you know, and pray that this is something that grows and expands into a community of really loving and accepting people. And I mean, everybody's going to have a difference of opinion. And I respect that, you know, and if you guys give me constructive criticism, I take it. I respect that. But I am not going to tolerate the immaturity. I am not going to tolerate the disrespect to my audience. If you don't like what I do, like I said, you can just keep moving. You know, I'm not forcing you to be here. You don't have to like what I do. You can say I suck. That's fine. But when you're making, you know, the chat area a place where people can't even enjoy the game, then what's the point of having a gaming community when we can't come together and be respectful and tolerant of people's differences and people's experiences? So I leave you with that, my friends. Like I said, I love you guys. Thanks so much for watching. And like I always say, remember,